in bus, each player controls a bus to pick up passengers and drop them off at their destinations in order to earn the most points and win the game. First, shuffle the 12 street cards and create a shared city grid by randomly placing cards to create the game board. Next, shuffle the 15 passenger cards and place them in a stack in the playing area. Then, flip two cards face up. Finally, all players take a bus card and choose a side of the city grid for their own progress area. Bus is a bit tricky in that each player will have a virtual progress area on one of the sides of the city grid. A player's progress area is divided into two sides under the two street cards on their side of the city grid. During the game, a player's passenger cards will be placed in their progress area as a way to keep track of which passengers have been picked up and which passengers have been dropped off. Each passenger card has two passengers, which are treated as individuals and whose progress is tracked separately. When a player acquires a passenger card after ending his turn on a bus stop, it is placed under the left street card and both passengers on the card are considered picked up. Then, when this player moves past or lands on one of the passengers' destinations, the player tracks this information in the progress area by moving that passenger to the dropped-off section, which is under the right street card in front of a player. It's common to reflect this progress in the opposite order that passengers are shown on the card by placing it upside down. On the street cards, there are 6 passenger destinations, 3 bus stops, and 1 construction site. On a player's turn, he will choose which route to move his bus throughout the city grid in order to efficiently achieve pickups and drop-offs in the fewest amount of street cards. In the first round of turns, players will choose a bus stop on which to place their bus. On all turns after the first, players will move their bus on the street cards, possibly dropping off passengers or picking up new ones at the end of their movement. To start the game, choose a start player. He must place his bus on any street card with a bus stop, with the construction site used side down. Then, he must choose a face-up passenger card or the top card from the deck and place it on the picked-up side in his progress area. During the game start and throughout the game, passenger cards are replaced immediately so that there are exactly 2 passenger cards face-up to choose from at any time. The next players in clockwise direction perform the same action. Buses may occupy the same street card during this step and throughout the game. Players continue taking turns in clockwise order. On a player's turn, he must move his bus. When a player moves his bus throughout the city grid, he must comply to his own speed limit and the direction in which his bus is headed. The arrow on a bus indicates the forward direction the bus must move, and it may never make a U-turn. A player's speed limit is the maximum number of street cards he may move his bus in a single turn. This limit is established by the lowest speed shown among all his passenger cards in progress. A player may move less than his speed limit, and if a player has no passenger cards in progress, then he has no speed limit to restrict movement. A bus may not end its movement sequence on the same street card in which it began. When a player ends his movement sequence on a bus stop, he may choose a face-up passenger card or draw one from the deck. Then, he must place it on the picked-up side in his progress area. The maximum passenger cards a player may have in progress is 3. Once the deck and face-up passenger cards are exhausted, players may not acquire new cards. To drop off a picked-up passenger and earn points, a player's bus must travel through or end its movement sequence on a passenger destination of the same color. The passenger is automatically dropped off, and the passenger card can be moved to the dropped-off side in his progress area. Once both passengers have been moved to the dropped-off side, the card is complete and flipped face down for in-game scoring. The speed limit on completed passenger cards no longer applies, and the speed limit on a player's next turn will be his lowest speed on his passenger cards in progress. A player's speed limit does not change during a turn. A player may land on the construction site street card at any time. Once during the game, he may end his movement sequence on the site to swap 2 street cards that are unoccupied by a bus. Then, he flips his bus over with the arrow facing in the same direction, showing he may not use the site again. After a turn in which a player has 5 or more passenger cards completed, the player triggers the end of the game. Then, each player gets one more turn, including the player who triggered the end game. Players flip over their completed passenger cards and total their point values. Incomplete passenger cards have no value. The player with the most points wins. In the case of a tie, the player with the most completed passenger cards is the winner. For a more challenging game, play with all the same rules, except a player's bus must be on the same side of the street as the bus stop, passenger destination, or construction site to take those corresponding actions. Additionally, a player taking the construction site action may choose to rotate a single street card that is unoccupied by a bus instead of swapping two street cards.